Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Daily Cruz Prayer and or message. I hope everyone is doing well during these times. I myself, I'm doing well. So once I get on here and speak, I just saw that there was another shooting, police shooting, this time in Wisconsin. And so I just wanted to speak about that. Look, out of all of the careers, this is my opinion, out of all careers here, let's just keep it in the United States, the career that needs their employees to be balanced is that of the police officer. That career, walking around with a gun, protected and serving, those people, out of all of the people, those are the people who need to have balance in their minds, in their body, and in their soul. They need balance because they have to be able to critically think, to be quick on their feet, to be able to have discernment, to know what's going on around here, so that they can make the most accurate decisions. The people who, I used to be a cop. I used to be in law enforcement, so that's why I can speak about this. Okay? I was out of balance as well when I was in law enforcement. Okay, I wasn't going out here shooting people and shit. That wasn't my job. But anyways, look. These police officers, many of them, I pray this message gets out to these people so that they can learn and know, because they don't even know. Many of them don't even know they're out of balance, so they can know and then learn how to get balanced. It takes a spiritual practice. You have to develop a spiritual practice. And I pray these people develop a spiritual practice, not one where they go to church on Sundays and read scriptures and give tithes and shit. That is not balance. That's not energetic. That's not going to energetically balance them. That is a distraction, because they are still out of balance. I don't care how many scriptures they read, how much tithes they give, how many times they talk to the preacher or the priests. If their energy is out of balance and if their mind is out of whack, they should not even be carrying a gun. Okay? I'm just saying, they shouldn't even be carrying a gun. But if they are in that profession, they, in my opinion, have to develop a spiritual practice to where they're grounded. You know what I'm saying? If you are a cop and you are have a lot of fear inside of you, paranoid, schizophrenic, and you're walking around with a gun, that is not a good combination for the innocent. Okay? So look, there are demons, spirits, dark spirits, and they jump on the humans. And they have the humans out of balance, okay? That is what is going on around here. That's why we see what we see right now. That's why we are being exposed to all of this shenanigans. Let's just say that. Okay? So look. It's so funny because look, okay. Just the other day, God sent me down, you know, I was going down memory lane, right? And I went down this street, and it was a street. God sent me on that street because I needed to heal. You see, when I was a kid, it was a bunch of us. We were playing around on the street. You know, we were into sports. We wasn't into anything mischievous when we were children. We was just playing sports and playing around, being kids. So a cop came. He came after us. I don't know what made him come to us. You know, I don't remember how it happened, but he stopped his car, got out of his car, and was telling us something, and we ran. You know, we ran. We like, ah. And so we was over there by a cemetery, and I remember I was about, I think I want to say 8 years old or something like that, 9, maybe 10. And I went to hop the fence because we were running, and we hopped the fence. We was about to, you know, hop the fence, and the cop pulled his gun out on us. And we froze, like, on the fence and shit, mid-hop, like, oh, shit. And then we came down off the fence and shit. I'm just glad he didn't pull that trigger. You know, he would have shot me in my back or one of my friends. You know, and it's just the heat of the moment like that. It happens just like that. You know, it could have been like that. That's why it is so important, not only for cops, for all of humanity, to develop a spiritual practice to keep them balanced so that they can, you know, think, be ready. You know what I mean? But hopefully one day that'll come. Right now, we're not there yet. So I'm just doing my part to spread the word, spread the message. Balance is key. If you can get balanced, everything else will fall into place. I remember when, you know, like I said earlier, I was in law enforcement, right? I was an ICE agent, Immigration Customs Enforcement, deportation officer, okay? So when I was doing that, every 90 days, right, we'll have a defensive tactics. It was like some training, you know, cop training, right? So let me tell y'all this story real quick before I let you go. So we was doing this training, right? And so sometimes on those training days, we'll have scenarios, right? So I'm going to tell you about the scenario that I went through. Okay, so look, it was a bunch of us, right? So each officer, one by one, will go into the room, and then it's like action. You gotta show the instructors, you know, what you're all about, right? So, now mind you, I walked in. I had like a, you know, they give you a plastic gun, you know, a simulation gun or whatever. And so I walk into the room, and the other cop, so the scenario is this: your partner is in there dealing with a civilian, and you got to go in there and assist your partner, or, you know, see what's going on. Not assist your partner, but go in there and then just evaluate the situation, right? So I went in there, and, you know, they're acting. So my partner, another cop, is beaten on the, so there's a person laying down, and the cop, my partner, is beating the person on the ground, beating them, boom, boom, boom. And the person on the ground is unresponsive, is laying there and shit. Beating the person on the ground, that's what I see when I walk in. He just beating the person. And he tells me, help me, help me. If this person is this, that, help me, help me. Right? Do you know, I gotta tell you this, because it was a bunch of us who did it one by one. We went in that scenario. After it was all said and done, everyone in that training class helped out the cop and started beating the person that was already on the ground. They started assisting their partner in whatever, they was cuffing the man up and shit and doing all types of shit to the man. I was the only one who pulled my fake gun out on my partner and said, what you doing? What are you doing? I had to cuff up my partner. My partner was like, why are you cuffing me up? Why are you cuffing me up? I'm like, you tripping right now. What are you doing? I cuffed him up. I was the only one who did that shit. And I was a zombie. I was sleepwalking. I hadn't had my awakening yet. But I had some type of common sense back then. So just, I just want to talk about that. Because it's just like that. It's because when you're out of balance, you automatically, you know, you just, I don't know. I can't explain. I can't articulate that very much. It's just like, if you're out of balance, you're just more, you're more reactive. And that's basically what happened to a lot of my coworkers at that time. They went on ahead and just was reacting to, they figured, well, if my partner is doing that, it must be right. So let me go ahead and do what my partner's doing. It can be that easy. And I know a lot of people have been through that. A lot of cops. They see one of their partners doing that or one of their coworkers doing some shit and they just go along with it because they think it's, you know, correct. So I just pray that these officers, they should have like a mandate or something. Like every police precinct, is that how you say it? Precinct, should have like some type of spiritual practice or some shit like that. Like they should have like a test, like a spiritual test. I don't know how they can do it. Some of these scientists can come up with some shit to find out if you balanced or not. A test to see if you're out of balance, then you got to take your ass home for that day. Put your gun up. Take your ass home until you can get balanced, and then you can come on back to work. Just do some shit like that. Anyways, I just wanted to get on here and talk about that. I pray this message gets out. Take good care of yourself. All right? I love you. God bless you. Bye.